right. We are about to head out. No pre-workout meal today because we're having a little cookout after the gym. So I want to save as many calories as I can for that. We're going to do a bit of an edit today. So see how creative I can get. I'm still filming on the phone in the gym because this thing is huge and there's not a lot of space and I don't want to get kicked out. So we'll feel it out as time goes on. But for now, let's see how creative we can get with the phone. Roll the music, start the music, start that at 3, 2, 1. Let's get it. What is up, guys? Just look at this, a 2-day vlog. Haven't done one of these in a while. It is officially Saturday, 2 weeks out from the Summer Shredding Classic. And I am excited and also extremely ready for this show to happen because I am exhausted. Exhausted, but there's no time for excuses. I woke up the leanest I've ever been today, the lowest weigh-in of prep, so I feel good about that. But other than that, I just feel lethargic, tired, not healthy, but like I've said many times, what I'm doing here isn't healthy. This isn't fitness. This is a fitness challenge that is taken to a very extreme level. So as always, for you guys watching this, disclaimer, this isn't what I preach about fat loss. This isn't how I preach sustainable fitness. This is simply, I wanted to push my body as hard as possible for a fitness competition to see if we could win it or at least place very well. Okay, one major tip I actually have. I know I just film myself pegging the K-Cup at the Keurig every morning, but I actually do wanna say that coffee, if you can make it low calorie, but like really enjoyable, so you sip on it for a long part of the morning. All right, what's up, guys? Future editing Will here. I'm realizing as I'm editing this vlog that I'm still figuring out my microphone. And I think I had like a dying battery because a lot of my clips, I don't have any sound for. So to finish out this vlog, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna throw all the workout footage I have together and I'm gonna do a little voiceover, you know, a little throwback. I haven't done a voiceover in a while. Give you guys some tips over, you know, about what I'm thinking while I'm doing these workouts. So let's hop into that. I hope you guys enjoy it. Hope you guys have enjoyed these videos. This one was a little hodgepodge, a little thrown together because I got backed up on my clips with some of the stuff that I had to get done this weekend. But trust me, the next couple of vlogs are gonna be fire. I've really put a lot more effort into the filming and kind of the design of them. So look forward to those. Like, comment, subscribe, all that great stuff. Your guys' support is actually really like just blowing me away and like helping me a ton, like more than you guys know. Thank you so much. It's helped me a lot on prep, for real. All right, enough sappy crap. Let's get into this voiceover. Let's get into this workout. All right, guys, so we had a hamstring only workout on the menu today. A little bit of quads, a little bit of glutes, but it's really just a hamstring focus. Again, I do 2 leg days per week. I try to focus on the quads on one of them and the hamstrings on the other. So we started off with stiff-legged deadlifts. And Only reason I'm doing these on the Smith machine is because that's what we have at the gym that I have. Usually I would do these, you know, with a free weight, but I do like, especially towards the end of prep, doing more things on machines. It provides more stability, allows you to feel the muscle contract a little better, and it reduces any risk of injury you might have because you're pretty fatigued, at the start of your workouts, let alone, you know, towards the end of them. So after that, sticking with the Smith machine, I moved into a kind of specialized lunge. Now these you do want to do on the Smith machine. What you'll see here is my foot's actually really far forward. What that's allowing me to do is it puts my foot way out in front of my knee, causing me to really have to drive through my hamstring and my glute, and then I actually bring my leg all the way through and kick it up and squeeze at the top. And it's a really great way to isolate your hamstring. If you're doing lunges and your knee's really coming over your toes, that's gonna emphasize more of the quads. When I really sit back, I stay upright like this, and I'm able to lock in that position, it targets the hamstring insanely well. And even though I'm men's physique, I don't show the legs, I still like to train legs. You wanna have a full, complete physique, regardless of what category you're in or what goals you may have. So just because I don't show them on stage doesn't mean I don't train them and I don't train them hard. Although we're only doing 95 pounds here, I'm going very slow, controlled, and we're doing a lot of volume, 5 to 6 sets on all of the things you're going to be seeing today. So after that, I move into seated leg curls. The number one tip I have for these is make sure you set the machine up properly before you get into it. Really take your time before that first set. Play around with it, stand up, get back into it a couple times. You want it to feel optimal before you start, because when you find that perfect balance, the squeeze and contraction you get in the muscle you're targeting, regardless of what the machine is gonna be way better than if you're not really set up right. So I have this set up perfectly for my leg length and how I curl with my hamstrings, and it works really well. Lastly, we have cable pull-throughs. These look kind of funky. You're basically just hump in the air, but you know what, they work really well for the hamstrings. So what I focus on here is I don't think of shooting my hips back, I think of bringing my hands down, and my hips will naturally go backwards. I'm not super flexible, so as you can tell, I'm not getting a ton of range of motion here, but trust me, it is stretching my hamstrings and really causing a lot of tissue damage. I do these to end, and again, we did, I think, somewhere around like 20 reps per set here. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, please leave a comment down below. Tell me your favorite part. Subscribe to the channel for more. And I don't know. That's all I got for today. I'll see you guys in tomorrow's video. Peace.